Hello everyone, welcome guys. I am Nachiket Wadekar and we were seeing thermodynamics, and in thermodynamics we have covered the introduction part. Then we have seen different types of systems which we are going to study in thermodynamics. What is system, what is surrounding, what is universe. Then we have seen extensive properties, intensive properties, right? Then go through the video, you will understand majority of the concepts which are very important for the upcoming concepts of thermodynamics. If the previous video is not seen by you, please go through that video and then go for the second lecture. Okay, in second lecture we are going to study the state functions and path functions. In state functions we are knowing that there are state functions means what, which are dependent on the initial and final states of reactants and products, while as path functions are those functions which are dependent upon the way the process takes place. Means the way by which A goes to B is the function which is known as path function, and work is an example of path function. So today we are going to see, first understand how work is path function, and then we will try to solve the examples based on that. Okay, so now here I have written some derivations which we are going to go through, but first I will tell you the concepts or sign conventions which are very very important. In that, when the system is system, now this is our system, in this what is happening is, if I can say, if I have this container is filled with H2O2 liquid and I have placed a piston on that container. With time, H2O2 will dissociate and those will give you gases of water and oxygen molecules, correct? So with time, what will happen? The piston will move up, and the volume will go on increasing. Now we are moving from A to B, right? The piston is moving up, that means the system is doing work on the surrounding. In that case the sign convention is negative. And when there is compression, for another example I will take that, if I am having NH3 and HCl, NH3 and HCl gases, and I am making them to react with each other, they will give me NH4Cl which is in solid state. This is in gaseous state, HCl is also in gaseous state. Gases will have higher volume than solid, means what, initially what will happen, the piston will be at a particular height. With time, with reaction, the piston will go on decreasing its height and you will get solid NH4Cl. Means now what is happening, the surrounding is doing work on the system, that's why the sign will be positive. So when the system does work on the surrounding, in this case when system does work on the surrounding, sign convention is negative, as I have shown over here. And when surrounding does work on the system, means when there is decrease in the height of the piston, that means what, the surrounding is doing work on the system, in that case the sign convention is positive. Now why I am saying work as path function, that is because work can be done reversibly and irreversibly in these two different conditions. Now here this is an expression for irreversible work. Irreversible work means what, from A to B, my system is moving from A state to B state directly. It is moving directly to B. There are no infinite steps, as I have written over here. In this diagram you can see that stepwise there is small change in the volume. This dV is what? Small change, right? So in this case, reversible means what? If I will, here you can see that I have decreased the weight over here. Here there were first 5 weights, here now we are having 4, 3 and 2. Means what is happening, the weight is going on decreasing. If I wish to reverse back, means if I wish to come back to step 2 from step 3, what I will need to do is, I will need to increase the weight. Means I will just add a weight over here, I can come back to the initial state, correct? Means reversible means what, you can come back to its original state at any condition and there won't be any considerable change in the system. In this case what is happening, if you try to increase the weight, you can't reach to your initial state as it was in previous state. So this is an irreversible change, and this is what reversible change. Reversible means you can revert back up after first or second step to its initial state. So these are the expression for reversible work, and this is expression for irreversible work. Now in irreversible work, we know the formula for work. Work is equal to what? Force into displacement. Now in this condition, which condition? Where my system is doing work on the surrounding, means my system is doing work on the surrounding, it is increasing, the piston is moving up, system is doing work on the surrounding. So in that case there is opposing force, that's why I will show negative sign over here. So work is what? Negative. System is doing work on the surrounding, negative sign. Work is what? Force into displacement. Now the force which is acting over here will be what? The area of the piston and the distance covered by that, distance covered by the piston. What I am saying is that the force is equal to what? Force is equal to pressure into area. So we can also say that pressure is equal to force upon area. Pressure is equal to what? We all generally know that pressure is equal to force acting per unit area. Okay, now I need what? Force. So I can directly multiply pressure into area. In this way I have got external pressure into area multiplied over here. Now area is what? Area is of the piston which we are having, and external pressure is what? Represented by PEX. So while I will substitute the value of force in the above equation, I will get the equation as minus P external into A into D. Now A is what? Area, and D is what? The distance covered by the piston. So from A to B my piston is moving. Now if I will try to draw this in 3 dimension, the piston is circular, it is moving from A state to B state, means it has covered this much path. Okay, now when you will see over here, this is what? Area, and this is what? Distance of the piston or displacement of the piston. So this will give you the volume of cylinder. Okay, area into distance covered or displacement of the piston will give you the volume of that cube, which is, or volume of that cylinder which is covered. That's why it is shown by delta V, and change in volume means what? V2 minus V1. So delta V is represented by volume, which is represented by V2 minus V1. When we substitute this value over here, we get W is equal to minus P external into delta V. Means I can substitute value of A and D as delta V, and I get the expression for irreversible work. This is expression for irreversible work. In this way, we have derived the equation for irreversible work. Now, when we go for reversible work, in that case, what happens is, I am having small weights placed on the piston which acts as pressure over there, which is represented by PT or total pressure. Okay, I can write down that P also or PT also, it does not matter. I will write P over there. So what is happening? The total pressure which is experiencing over here is represented by P. I am releasing the pressure, means I am releasing the pressure, that is small dp, which is weight which is given over there. That small weight can be represented by dp, that is small change in pressure. Dp means what? Change in pressure, difference in pressure. So that is what this weight is, small dp, which is written over here. Now when I will remove that dp, the pressure experienced by this container in second step will be represented by P external. Okay, is this clear? There are total 10 weights over here. Those 10 weights count total pressure. Each weight is small pressure, which is represented by dp. From those 10 weights I have removed one weight, and I am having now 9 weights over here. Those 9 weights are known as external pressure. Altogether, those 9 weights will be known as what? External pressure, and which is represented over here. Now, as we all know from the equation, that small change, small work done. Here, what is happening? The volume is increasing, means small amount of work is done. Small amount of volume is increasing means small amount of work is done, which is represented by dW, which is small amount of work is done. So, dW is equal to pressure into volume. small change in volume. This expression I have written over here. Small amount of work, small change in volume. The total pressure acting is external pressure. Now, if I will try to find out the value of P external, it will be what? P minus dP. P minus dP will give me P external value. This total pressure minus dP will give me P external, which I have written over here. Okay. Now, substituting the value of P external in the work function, negative sign is as it is. I have substituted the value for P external over here, then multiplied dV inside the bracket, and I got this equation where negative sign is multiplied to dP and I get positive sign over there. Now, dP dV is very infinite small change, very infinite small change, so which can be neglected. So dP dV is neglected and I am keeping it as minus P dV. Okay, now these are what? Infinitesimal change, small change. These small changes combine together to move from, to find out the maximum work from A to B. Now we are going from, we are carrying out the same process. We are moving from A to B, but what is happening is we are going stepwise. Here there was irreversible process. Now we are moving stepwise from A to B, and there are infinite steps when we are moving from A to B. Here I have directly shown the representation, but there are n number of steps which are given over here. Okay. Now when we integrate, integration means what? Adding up all the small changes. So when we integrate, the work will be represented as from W1 to W2 and volume V1 to V2. Means this is, this whole will be represented by volume V1 and this whole will be represented by volume V2. This whole will be V2. Okay. Now we are moving from V1 to V2, which is written over here. Now, as we know, by ideal gas equation, PV is equal to nRT. So P is equal to nRT by V. Now, when we substitute these values in our equation, we will get as W1, W2, dW is equal to, substituting the value of P over here, nRT by V, integration dV. These are what? Common terms. Here we are having V1 to V2. Taking the common terms out, minus nRT, V1, V2, 1 by V, dV. Now this whole term can be represented by maximum work done, or represented by W max. Now, as we all know that integration of 1 upon x dx is equal to log to the base e x. Integration of 1 upon x dx is equal to log to the base e x. Substituting that value over here, minus nRT log to the base e v, upper limit and lower limit. These are the limits which I have written over here. Now, when we will substitute upper limit and substitute the lower limit, we will get the equation like this, where W max is equal to what? Minus nRT log of V2 minus log of V1, and this log is log to the base E, which can be also written as ln. Now we can write down this as minus nRT ln of V2 upon V1. Now, when we are going to try to solve the examples, in that case we are having log table, which is log to the base 10. Now, when we convert ln to the log to the base 10, we multiply this whole equation by minus 2 point, we multiply this number by 2.303. Okay? nRT log of V2 upon V1. So, this is our final expression for maximum amount of work done in our reversible reaction. So this is a reversible process where we get the maximum amount of work. Now here what I have done is I have converted this ln to log to the base 10 and I have multiplied 2.303 number to the given equation. Okay. In this way we can convert ln to log form. So this is the final and final expression for reversible and irreversible work, where majority of the times in boards they ask you questions, derive the expression for maximum amount of work done, or they can give you the examples based on that. So next, now we are going to try to solve the examples for maximum amount of work done. I will tell you the way by which you are going to solve. I'll bring log table and I'll let you know two examples how to solve them, because those are very confusing. As I'll explain with the help of log, you will understand it. I'll pause the video. Wait for me. Otherwise, I have brought log table with me. Now we will solve the examples. I'll dictate the examples and try to solve those examples. First, we will see simple examples based on reversible and irreversible. How, first thing is, whether when we are provided with the example, how to identify which is reversible process and which is irreversible process. Specifically, it is explained in your example whether the system is following reversible process or irreversible process. Now take some examples. Two molecules of an ideal gas are expanded isothermally from a volume of 15.5 liters to the volume of 20 liters against a constant external pressure of 1 atmosphere. Against a constant external pressure of 1 atmosphere, estimate the amount of work in liter atmosphere and joule. Estimate the amount of work done in liter atmosphere and joule. Now first thing what we will write down is, first we will write down given, and we have to find out the maximum amount of work done. Whether, now in this example, when you will see, it is not explained us whether the reaction is reversible or irreversible. If it is specifically mentioned that the reaction follows reversible process, then we will use the expression of W max. In this example, it is not represented that it is a reversible process, so we are going to simply use the formula of W is equal to minus P external into delta V. Now what all things you are going to require is P external and delta V. Delta V means what? V2 minus V1. So we will need the volumes and external pressure. Now what is given to us is that expands isothermally from, so initial volume is given from 15.5 liters to 20 liters, means V2 will be 20 liters. And what is the external pressure? External pressure is of 1 atmosphere. So W max will be what? Minus 1 atmosphere into delta V is V2 minus V1, 20 minus 15.5 liters. So this is equal to what? 4.5 liter atmosphere. Now we have got the work in liter atmosphere. Next we have to find the value in joules. Now to find the value in joules, we will directly multiply it by 101.3. So when we multiply work, that is 4.5 into 101.3, it will give us the answer in joules. So after multiplying, we get the answer to be at minus 455.8 liter atmosphere. Here we are having negative sign, that negative sign should be carried forward. So this is in joules. Always remember, when we are converting liter atmosphere into joules, we will be directly multiplying the answer by 101.3. that is the number. Okay, this is simple 1 mark or 2 marks example, which is generally asked to in section B part of the question paper. This is simple example. We will take next one more example, and then we will move for the difficult part. Calculate the constant external pressure required to compress 1 mole of an ideal gas. To compress 1 mole of from a volume of 2 liters to 8 liters from a volume of 2 liters to 8 liters when the work obtained is 44.9 liter atmosphere. Now what is asked? External pressure. We have to find out the P external. Work is given to us 44.9 liter atmosphere. Then we are having V1 and V2. Now V1 will be what? The compression is going on, the system is getting compressed. That means what? The initial volume will be V1 will be 20 liters and V2 will be 8 liters. Whether the system is getting compressed or it is expanding, based on these two conditions, whether the system is getting compressed or expanding, based on these two conditions, V1 and V2 changes. Okay. So substituting these values, first we will need to find out the value of delta V. Delta V will be what? V2 minus V1. So it is 80 minus 20, which gives us minus 12 liters. Now this is minus 12. Means what? This negative sign will go up with the negative sign which we are having over here, and we will have the work as minus P external into delta V. Delta V is minus 12, so minus minus will become plus, and we will get work as 44.9 is equal to P external into 12. So when we divide this 44.9 by 12, we will get the external pressure, and that external pressure will be in atmosphere. Here we are having work in atmosphere, so the pressure will be in atmosphere. So the answer for that is 3.74 atmosphere. You can do log calculations and try to relate the answers with your log calculations. This was our second example. Now we will go for the next example. Try to write down that example. 3 moles of an ideal gas. 3 moles of an ideal gas are expanded isothermally and reversibly from 10 meter cube to 20 meter cube at 300 Kelvin. Calculate the work done. 3 moles of an ideal gas means N is given. 3 moles of an ideal gas is expanded isothermally and reversibly. Isothermally means what? The temperature is remaining constant of the system. And reversibly means what? We are going to use the formula for maximum work, because it is a reversible process. So W max will be our formula, where we are provided with the initial and final volumes. Expansion means initial will be 10 meter cube and final will be 20 meter cube. In expanding, what will happen? The volume will increase. So final volume will be maximum always. Now temperature is given. Temperature is 300 Kelvin. And what else is given? Calculate the work done, where R is 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. Now we are going to try to relate these units with Kelvin is remaining Kelvin, mole is mole, means we don't need to change the units over here. So maximum work, W max will be equal to what? 2.303 minus 2.303 nRT log of V2 upon V1. Now are we provided with N? Yes, 3 moles. Now we will substitute these values. Minus 2.303 into 3 into R, that is 8.314, into P, that is temperature, 300 Kelvin, into log of V2 upon V1. So that is 20 upon 10. This 10 gets cancelled, we get log of 2, and value of 2 is 0.3010. So minus 2.303 into 3 into 8.314 into 300. Now we are having log 2. We will see the value of log 2 in our log table. So in log table, the value of 20 is 0.3010. It is one digit number, so 1 minus 10, that's why 0.3010. 1, 0. Now when we will see the log values of all these three, we can directly multiply here. 3 3s are 9, and based on that we can solve ahead. -2.303 × 900 × 8.314 × 0.3010. Remember, this is log value. Now when we are going to solve this with the help of log, what we are going to do is we are going to see the log value of each and every number. I will tell you how we are going to solve with the log table. First we will, now here all the terms are multiplied, so we are going to add all the terms and then we are going to see the anti-log of those additions. So first we are going to see the value for 2.303, so that is a single digit number. So 1 minus 1 0, we will see the value of 23 0 and 3. Value of 3 is 6 3 6 1 6 3 6 1 7, plus 6. Means 3 6 2 3. 3 6 2 3 plus log of 900. So we will see the value of 90 in 0, 9542.9542. It is 3 digit number, so 3 minus 1 2, so that will be 2 point. Next 8.314, so we will see the value of 83 in 1 and 4. Here we are having 8, it is single digit number, so 1 minus 1 0, and we will see the value of 83 in 1 and 4. 83 1 9196, and 4 is 2, so we get 9198 plus log. Again we are going to see the log of 31. Now we are having 10, that is bar 1, and we will see the value of log of 30 in 1. So 4771. We will add these numbers now. 8 9 10 4. Now this 2, we will get 3.7134. Now we will see the antilog of 71 in, we will see the antilog of 71 in 3 and 4. So antilog of 71 is in 3 and 4 is 5169. So we get 5169. Here we are having 3, so 3 plus 1, 4, we will put a point after 4 digits, so 5139 point. What I have done here, I have got 2, 2 plus 2, 4, this is bar 1, bar 1 gives me 3. So 5169 is our final answer. Okay, 51690 joules is the answer which we will get over here. In this way, we can solve the example. I'll take one more example which will help you to understand more properly. Take down. 280 millimole of a perfect gas occupies 12.7 liters. 280 millimole of a perfect gas occupies 12.7 liter at 81 Kelvin. Calculate the work done when the gas expands isothermally and reversibly. When the gas expands isothermally and reversibly against a constant external pressure of 0.25 atmosphere, against a constant external pressure of 0.25 atmosphere, until the volume increases by 3.3 liters. Until the volume increases by 3.3 liters. So here we will try to solve that example. First we are going to write down given. In given, 280 millimoles. 280 millimoles means N is given. 288 millimoles. please do the correction. No, 286, sorry. 288, 280 millimoles occupies V1 initial volume of 12.7 liters and temperature is 310 Kelvin. Calculate the work done when the gas expands isothermally and reversibly, and the expansion is given by 3.3 liters. Means what we will need to do, 12.7 plus 3.3 liters. Why I am adding this? Because they have not given us the final volume. They have just said that the volume increases by 3.3. So I will add that and I will get the final volume as 16 liters. Correct? I will get V2 as 16 liters. Now we will substitute these values in our equation. What else do we need? We need the value of R. So value of R is 8.314, which is generally given to us. Yes, R is 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. Now W max is equal to minus 2.303 into nRT log of V2 upon V1. Now we will need to convert this millimole into mole. Now when we are going to convert millimole into mole, we will multiply it by 10 raised to minus 3. So when we multiply this by 10 raised to minus 3, we get 0.28 moles. We are converting millimoles into moles. It is like millimeter into centimeter or meters in that way. So we will substitute the values over here. W minus 2.303 into N 0.28 into 8.314 into log of 16 minus divided by 12.7. Now first we will need to see the log of this term. So log of 16 is what? I will see in the log table. Log of 16 is 1.2041. Minus here also 1 point, seeing the log of 12 in 7, 1038. Subtracting them, we will get 0.1003. So the value of this whole bracket will be written over here, minus 2.303 into 0.28 into 8.314 into 0.1003. Now we will see the log value for all these terms, all the four terms, and add them. So first we will see the log of 2.303. I will clean it. Log of, we are going to add all the logs because they all are multiplied with each other. So here 2.303, the value is 2 points, so that is 0.23603 plus bar 1 point, value of 28 in 0, 4472 plus 8.314, value of 8.314 will be what? 0.83 in 1 and 4. 9198 plus bar 1 point 10, 0 and 3, that will give us 0012. Now we will add these four terms. I'll have bar 1 over here. 1 and 1 gets cancelled, I'll remain with bar 1. Now you'll see the anti-log of 73 in 0 and 5. 73 in 0 and 5 is 6, 5376. 5, 3, 7, 6. And bar 1 means it is 0.5376. So the maximum amount of work done, W max, will be equal to what? 0.2535373. And what will be the unit? Unit will be in joules. Okay? We have not multiplied temperature over here. What is the temperature? 310. We will multiply 310 over here. Means in this answer, when we will multiply 310, we will get the final answer. Here we are having addition of all these terms. We will add the log of 310 in that. So adding log of 310, 310, that is 4914. It is 3 digit number, so 2 points, adding them, 9, 1, so it is 2.2219. We will see the anti-log of 22 in 1 and 9. Just a moment, I will check the log value of 31 in 0, 4914, correct. Now we will see the anti-log, 2219, 22 in 1 and 9, 166, that is 1663, okay. Now we are having 2, so 2 plus 1, 3, after 3 numbers we will put a point and write down the unit as joules, and here we are having minus sign which is carried over from the top. So W max will be equal to minus 166.3 joules. So in this way we can solve the expression and examples for maximum amount of work done. In next video we will see zeroth law of thermodynamics. Next video we will be seeing zeroth law of thermodynamics, first law of thermodynamics, and try to see the changes taking place in the first law of thermodynamics. Thank you. I hope you might have understood these examples. Go through the examples which are solved examples and try to solve unsolved examples also. If you have any doubt, you can write down in the comments. I'll try to answer that in the next video. Thank you.